It was keeping me from my quiet time in prayer and Bible study with God. I was spending more time in front of that computer screen than I was in my Bible, and than I was on my knees. And I had to let it go. I had to cut it out. And maybe someday God will give that back to me. I don't know. But for now, it was an idol, and it's out of my life. I don't know what your idols are. Another one for me might be NASCAR. It's speed week, you know? I mean, you know, right, brother? Brother Mike knows. It's speed week in Daytona. I mean, they've got on a speed channel. They've got NASCAR run 24 hours a day here this week. And I've missed most of it. And I'm going to miss it the rest of the week. But you know what? If it takes me away from these meetings, if it takes me away from my opportunity to worship God and to hear His Word and to see my life change, I don't want it in my life.
Right.
Last one is this. Genuine revival is restored worship. Starting in verse 21 of chapter 23. Among the things that Josiah found when he read the Word of God was that he saw the command for Israel to celebrate the Passover feast every year. The Passover was a time for them to remember how God had saved them out of their slavery in Egypt and taken them as His own people and made a covenant with them. It reminds them of the time when God had that plague of the firstborn. And the people put the blood on the doorposts. And God passed over their homes. And they were delivered. They were saved. They were redeemed out of their slavery. It's a picture of Jesus. Isn't it? Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, that Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. When revival comes, we will focus on Jesus and what He's done for us. His cross will become precious. His resurrection will become our life. His return will become our blessed hope. When we remember who Jesus is and what He's done for us, we cannot help but fall in love with Jesus again.
Amen.
Really, that's what revival is. Revival is when God's people fall in love with Him again. Here's what I want us to do. Let's stand together. I don't want to manipulate or converse anyone tonight. I just want us to take this to God. This was His word. It spoke to my heart. I hope it spoke to yours. Let's just bow our heads and let's spend a few moments getting honest with God about some things.